Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. I am Vitrivel, Associate Professor, Department of Physics, Rohini College of Engineering and Technology. In this video, we are going to discuss about the different types of polarizations in dielectrics, which is in the material science, PH 8251, for the first years. Course outcome. Upon completion of this course, the students will be able to explain different types of polarizations in dielectrics. Now let us see what is polarization in dielectrics. When a dielectric is placed in an external electric field E, the positive and negative charges are displaced from their equilibrium position by small distance throughout the volume of the dielectric. Now let us see what are dielectric materials. Dielectrics are nothing but insulators. They are not able to conduct electricity as well as heat, but they have the ability to store the electrical energy. So here, when the two charges are moving away from their equilibrium position, an electric dipole is produced. Thus, the process of producing electric dipoles by the application of an external electric field is called polarization in dielectrics. Here, when the external electric field is applied, the positive and negative charges are moving in opposite directions. But when the external electric field is removed, both the positive and negative charges will be moving to the original position. Various polarization mechanisms in dielectrics. Actually, there are four important types of polarizations available in dielectrics. The first one, electronic or induced polarization. The second one, ionic or atomic polarization. Third one, orientation polarization. And the fourth one, space charge or interfacial polarization. Now let us see the first one, electronic polarization. Actually, this electronic polarization occurs in atoms. Here we see electronic polarization occurs due to the displacement of positively charged nucleus and the negatively charged electrons in opposite directions when an external electric field is applied. We know that the atom consists of a positively charged nucleus at its center, and the electrons are revolving around the nucleus in various orbits around the nucleus. Without applying the electric field, the nucleus is present at the center of the atom and all the electrons are revolving around the nucleus, that is shown in the figure 1. Here we see at the center of the atom, the nucleus plus symbol is present, and the negative symbol represents the electrons. They are revolving around the nucleus. Now let us move to the second figure. When the external electric field is applied, the positive charged nucleus and the negatively charged electrons are moving in opposite directions. As a result, an electric dipole is produced. This type of polarization in the atom is called as electronic polarization. Now let us see the second one, ionic polarization. Ionic polarization occurs due to the displacement of positive and negative ions in opposite directions when an external electric field is applied. This type of polarization is occurred in ionic molecules such as sodium chloride, potassium bromide, and sodium chloride, etc. Here we see in the first figure, the positive and negative ions are separated at a small distance, d naught, as shown in the figure. That means this is the equilibrium position of the two charges, the positive and negative ions. Now, when we apply the external electric field, the positive and negative ions are moving away from the equilibrium position due to the application of the external electric field, so that the distance between the two ions will be increased. That is represented by small d in the figure. So when these two ions are moving away from each other, they are forming the dipoles. So now let us see what are dipoles. Dipoles are nothing but two equal and opposite charges separated by a small distance. The third polarization is orientation polarization. This polarization takes place only in polar dielectrics. The polar dielectrics have molecules with permanent dipole moments even in the absence of electric field. It is a peculiar characteristic of these polar molecules. That means polarization occurs when an external electric field is applied, so that the two charges will be moving away from their original position. But when the external electric field is removed, both the charges will come to the original position. But in the polar molecules, even though the external electric field is removed, the polar molecules retains the polarizations itself. That means the particle will not move to the original position even in the absence of the external electric field immediately. So that is the important characteristics of these polar molecules. Now let us see in the figure A, without the application of external electric field, the polar molecules are oriented in random directions. That means they have no order. Now let us see, the molecules are oriented, that means rotated in different positions as well as different directions. But when we see the second figure, when the external electric field is applied, what happens? All the polar molecules are aligned with respect to the applied electric field. Now clearly we can see all the polar molecules have a perfect order. So this type of order, that means the particles or the molecules are moving from their original position to another position, so that they form the dipole. This type of polarization is called as orientation polarization. Now let us see the fourth one. It is the last type of polarization, that is a space charge polarization. Now let us see what is space charge polarization. The space charge polarization occurs due to diffusion of ions along the field direction and giving rise to redistribution of charges in the dielectrics. Now let us see the figure 1. Without the application of electric field, the ions are present in random positions inside the dielectric material as shown in the figure. Now let us clearly see, the positive and negative charges are moving in a random direction. They have no perfect order. But when the external electric field is applied, let us move to the second figure. Now, due to the application of the external electric field, all the positive and negative charges are accumulated with respect to the applied electric field. That means all the positive charges are accumulated. Accumulated means collected or gathered very close to the negative electrode. At the same time, the negative charges are accumulated towards the positive electrode as shown in the figure. Anyway, there is a movement of the positive and negative charges in different directions, so that the polarization takes place. So this type of polarization, due to the accumulation of charges with respect to the particular electrodes, are called as space charge polarization. Now we have clearly discussed about the various types of polarization mechanisms in dielectrics. Thank you.